What's going on, YouTube? Today, we're going to be taking our Hogwarts Legacy Wizarding World Patronus test, house test, and wand test. It's going to be really, really fun, and this is going to lead us right into Hogwarts Legacy gameplay, which the video will be dropping a little bit after this video. Right down below, we'll also include a link to the website where you can take your own test and figure out what's your Patronus, what's your house, and what kind of wand you have. This all links right directly into the game if you end up do getting it. I am streaming on Twitch right now, probably, and this whole week, actually, for Hogwarts Legacy, and there will be drops, so if you want exclusive in-game items, go tune into the stream, come say what's up, and let's get right into the video. Okay, well, we can do this. The boy that shouldn't have lived. Harry Pothead. Boo Weasley.
Oh my god.
Before disposable diapers, all of them were washable. Okay. Okay, discover our Patronus. You can only discover your Patronus once the questions are timed. Go with your instincts. What? Relax and think of my happiest memory. Happiest memory. Glitter, shine, or glow? I didn't even pick. What? I didn't even click. Sun, wind, or rain? Sun. That was my first instinct there. That's why I picked it. Smooth or rough? Rough. Pause. Around, under, over. What? Over? Oh, excellent magic, you guys. Forever or sometimes? Forever. Forever and always. Oh, man. Listen, watch, or touch? Oh, the music's getting intense. Click, drag, and release for your Patronus. My Patronus is a Borzoi? What the fuck is that? It means that you find comfort in purpose. You're the sort of person that needs action in their life. If you're fenced in or sitting around twiddling your thumbs, you will not be a happy camper. You're easily bored, and so seek out and enjoy many hobbies and interests. I don't know if I believe the last part of that. I'm easily entertained. I got that dog. I got that dog in me. Shitty Graham dog. Okay, nice. I wonder how it looks like if I share this. What do they do? Dude, this music's intense, man. Okay, so. The Patronus is Borzoi. The Patronus turned. It was cantering back towards Harry across the still surface of the water. It wasn't a horse. It wasn't a unicorn either. It was a stag. Oh, this is from the book. Okay. Make your own Patronus lights. Whoa. Those look kind of scuffed. You don't like those skinny stick pops? All right, let's see if we can discover our house here. They really do. Oh, here we go. Here we go. All right, it's just because everybody's trying to get in. River or forest? I gotta go with river. A muggle confronts you and says that they are sure that you're a wizard or a witch. Do you ask what makes them think so? Tell them that you are worried about their mental health and offer to call a doctor. Agree and ask whether they'd like a free sample of a jinx. Agree and walk away, leaving them to wonder whether you are bluffing. Sure. What? Oh. Okay. You don't think this game's gonna do well? Are you serious? Or just because of the hater, or are you trolling about that, R. Davis? I think this game's gonna do really well. I think it's already doing well, and the game hasn't even fully released, or it's like not even the official release day, right? How would you like to be known to history? The great, the wise, the bold, the good. Oh, the great. For sure. If you were attending Hogwarts, which pet would you choose to take with you? Cats, toads, or owls? Oh, I gotta go with owl. If you were attending Hogwarts, which pet would you choose to take? Okay, barn owl. We got a tawny owl, a snowy owl, or a screech. Screech owl looks pretty cool, pretty feisty, but I like the snow owl, I think. Yeah. Either barn owl or snow owl. Let's go with the snow owl. Who knows, he can't be the one. Which of the following do you find most difficult to deal with? Loneliness? Nope, not a problem at all. Boredom? Nope. Hunger? Maybe. Being ignored? Or cold? Was there not? I thought there was only four, no? Hunger. My fat ass. Four goblets are placed before you. Which would you choose to drink? The smooth, thick, richly purple drink that gives off a delicious smell of chocolate and plums. Huh. There were five owls? Whoops. I thought each owl was supposed to symbolize, like, each house, you know? Or something. The mysterious black liquid that gleams from, like, ink and gives off fumes that make you see strange visions. Whoa. I might want to go see some visions. The foaming, frothing, silvery liquid that sparkles as though containing ground diamonds. Doesn't sound like it's that great. The golden liquid so bright that it hurts the eyes, which makes sunspots dance all around the room. I ain't trying to get no sunspots. Can I go back? Just go back? Could I do that? What is it, question four? Oh, fuck, man. Okay, river. A green walk away. The great. Owl. Screech owl. Oh, brown owl. Okay. Yeah, no. We're picking snowy owl. Hunger. Okay. Smooth, thick, richly purple drink that gives off delicious smell of chocolate and plums. Let's just go for the visions. You know, have a good time. If you could have any power, which would you choose? The power to read minds? The power to change the past? The power of invisibility? Ooh. The power to speak to animals? Interesting. The power of superhuman strength? the power to change your appearance at will. That's interesting. I don't think I would want the power to read minds. I don't really care too much. You know, people can think whatever they want to think. The power to change the past. You know, then you're always gonna be like regretting stuff. I feel like, and then wanting to go change it. Power of invisibility, maybe. Maybe that's a good one right there. Power to speak to animals is cool as well. That'd be interesting. Superhuman strength is always cool. As long as you can control it, right? If you have the superhuman strength, but you can't control it, you're just breaking stuff all the time, then it's just not as cool of an ability. And the power to change your appearance at will. I think shape-shifting is cool. So it's either shape-shifting or invisibility. They're kind of similar in that you can mask yourself, but just in different ways. I like invisibility. Just change your appearance to be invisible. You think so, huh? You can? I mean, can you do that? That's the thing. Because it's one of those things where, do you change your appearance to only other people? Can you change your appearance to animals too? To objects? You know, that's the interesting, or like, that's the part that would be interesting to see. What's going on, Eli? Thank you for the lurk. The super strength or the wankage? Sure. I'll entertain you with the changing appearance. Allows for more options. White or black? Interesting. There's literally black on the card too. Like on the side that you choose, and there's white over here. I don't know. I'm a dark mode user, so we'll go with black. Let's see what it gives us. The fuck? What? This website is so bugged. It's like, you don't get a house. It's like, bro, your answers, yeah, ejected from the house. Your answers were so shit that you don't deserve a house. Oh my god, bro. That's crazy. Yeah, my Patronus is a dog, though, you know? We got that dog in us, Johnny. We got that dog in us. Are you going to be playing today? They sending me to the doghouse. Okay, come on. Error. There we go. So, river. Once again, river, we agree and walk away. The great owls. Snowy owl. Hunger. We're definitely trying to see some strange visions. College rejection letters. Black. Okay. Oh, here we go, you guys. Here we go. You sent me your cards? What do you mean? For what? What do we got here? I swear to God, if this shit gizzles. If it straight gizzles it so. Oh, for okay, yeah, sounds good. I just had no clue what you're. I had no clue what you're sending me. I was like, dude, I'll give your cards away, Shane. Is that's what you're wanting? Hey, man, we'll give them away to the community. For sure. I'm a Slytherin? No way, dude. No shot. That's a lie. Yeah, it's because I'd be slithering in these hoes, man. Me and Splasher. All right, there we go. Pride, ambition, cunning. Slytherin. You probably know that some of Slytherin's most renowned members include Severus Snape and Bellatrix Lestrange. But did you know Merlin himself was a Slytherin? Or that according to legend, the ribbon of a first-class order of Merlin is green to reflect his Hogwarts house. Huh. Zero fellow Slytherins have been sorted into this ambitious Hogwarts house today. What? What? Fucking scabby. Okay, here we go. First of all, would you describe yourself as average height, tall, or short? I think I'm technically... What is the average height of a male? Average male height. Is it 6 foot? Oh, okay. I'm average. It says about 5'9". Boom. And your eyes. Dark brown, black, blue, gray, brown. Oh. I don't know what I am. Are they brown? I think they're brown. Dark brown. Now this is for my wand. We're choosing my wand now, Scabby. Yellow? We'll go with like a brown. Just regular brown. Buckeye! Busy, busy man, dude. You're just too busy, bro. Too popular, too famous, man. Just a mod everywhere, bro. Thank you so much for the 21 months, Buckeye. Welcome back, sir. I hope that you've been having a wonderful new year. Brown, because you're full of shit. Was the day on which you were born, it was odd. Do you most pride yourself on determination, imagination, resilience, intelligence, originality, optimism, kindness? Resilience, I would like to think. Traveling alone down a deserted road, you reach a crossroads. Do you continue left towards the sea, right towards the castle, ahead towards the forest? Whoa. Left towards the sea, right towards the castle, ahead towards the forest. Left towards the sea. I like the ocean. What's going on, Jed? What's going on, you guys? Yes, happy release day to all the people who are just tuning in. Happy release day. You're tuning into the best original series in the best spot for Hogwarts Legacy gameplay with none other than your host, Potter Vu. All right? So, thank you. Thank you for tuning in. Do you most fear fire, darkness, isolation, heights, or small spaces? Fire, darkness, isolation, heights, or small spaces? It's not like I have a phobia of any of these or any whatever you call it, but I guess out of any of them, maybe like tight spaces over the heights. Heights definitely get my palms a little clammy, you know? You start sweating a little, you look down, you're like, oh man, I'm pretty high up. It's not like I can't be up in a high place. I think small place is kind of like the most fear out of any of these. It's being just stuck and suffocated. In a chest of magical artifacts, which would you choose? Silver dagger? Ornate mirror, glittering jewel, bound scroll, golden key, dusty bottle, or black glove. Golden key, dusty bottle, black glove. I think I'll go with a bound scroll. There's gotta be hella knowledge in there. Dusty dildo. Yeah, claustrophobic. I wouldn't say I'm claustrophobic, but out of all of those, it's like being just in a super tight or narrow spot would suck. And I mean like really, really tight. You know those people that go, I don't know if it's called cave diving or something like that. You have to like fit through these tiny spots to get to the cave and stuff like that. And yeah, that being stuck in like those ones. If it's just like a small room, that's fine. Ooh, a laurel wand with a phoenix core. 10, bro, 10 and 3/4 inches and super flexible. And supple flexibility. Oh my goodness, you guys. Look at that. 10 and 3/4 inches. Are they trying to change it on me? The hell?